Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. We are pleased to welcome you sa press conference ng Philippine Statistics Authority para sa 2023 fourth quarter and full year 2023 performance of the Philippine economy ngayong 13 ng Enero 2024. Ako po si Angeli Aicardo at inyong host para sa press briefing na ito. Para po sa ating guests na nais makibahagi sa ating talakayan, ang event po na ito ay live-streamed sa PSA Facebook page at ang mga updates naman po ay tweeted sa PSA Twitter account gamit ang hashtag PHGDP. Ngayon, atin na pong pakinggan ang ulat ni PSA Undersecretary Claire Dennis S. Mapa.
Magandang umaga sa ating lahat. Ang Philippine Statistics Authority mag-uulat ng estado ng ekonomiya ng bansa sa ika-apat na quarter at kabuuang taon ng 2023. Ang gross domestic product o GDP ng Pilipinas ay nagdala ng pagtaas na 5.6% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023. Ito ay mula sa naitalang 7.1% na pagtaas sa parehong quarter noong nakalipas na taon. Sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang GDP ay nagdala ng pagtaas na 5.6%. Ito ay mula sa naitalang 7.6% noong taong 2022. Ang gross national income o GNI ay nagdala ng pagtaas na 11.1% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023. Gayun din, ang net primary income from the rest of the world ay tumaas ng 97.7% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023. Sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang GNI ay tumaas ng 10.5%. Samantala, ang net primary income ay tumaas din ng 96.6% sa kabuuang taon ng 2023. Sa seasonally adjusted national account sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023, ang GDP ay nagdala ng quarter-on-quarter na pagtaas na 2.1%. Sa kabilang dako, ang GNI ay nagdala ng 2.8% quarter-on-quarter na paglago sa parehas na period. Ang mga pangunahing sektor ng ekonomiya na agriculture, forestry and fishing, industry at services ay nagsipagdala ng pagtaas na 1.4%, 3.2% at 7.4% respectively. Sa kabuuang taon naman ng 2023, ang agriculture, forestry and fishing, industry at services ay nagsipagdala ng pagtaas na 1.2%, 3.6% at 7.2% respectively. Sa seasonally adjusted GDP, ang services ay nagdala ng pinakamataas na paglago sa mga pangunahing sektor na may 3.2% quarter-on-quarter basis. Sinundan ito ng industry ng pagtaas na 0.4% at agriculture, forestry and fishing na bumaba naman ng 0.02% quarter-on-quarter basis. Sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023, ang per capita GDP ay tumaas ng 4.4%. Ito ay mula sa pagtaas na 5.8% sa parehong quarter noong nakalipas na taon. Ang per capita GNI at per capita household final consumption expenditure ay parehong nakapagdala ng pagtaas ng 9.8% at 4.1% respectively. Sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang per capita GDP, per capita GNI at per capita household final consumption expenditure ay nakapagdala ng pagtaas ng 4.3%, 9.2% at 4.3% respectively. Sa naitalang pagtaas ng GDP na 5.8% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023, ang services sector ay nagdala ng may pinakamataas na contribution na 4.5 percentage points. Ito ay sinundan ng industry na nagdala ng contribution na 1.0 percentage point, habang ang agriculture, forestry and fishing ay nakapag-ambag ng 0.1 percentage point sa kabuuang pagtaas ng GDP. sa paglago ng ekonomiya na 5.6% sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang agriculture, forestry and fishing, industry at services ay nagsipagtala ng kontribusyon na 0.1 percentage point, 1.1 percentage points at 4.4 percentage points respectively. Sa 16 na sektor ng GDP, ang accommodation and food service activities ay nagtala ng pinakamataas na paglago na nasa 19.2% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023. Ito ay sinundan ng mga sumusunod: other services na tumaas ng 11.9%, financial and insurance activities na tumaas ng 11.8%, at mining and quarrying na tumaas naman ng 10.3%. Sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang accommodation and food service activities ay nagtala ng pinakamataas na paglago na nasa 23.4%. Ito ay sinundan ng other services na tumaas ng 20.9%, transportation and storage na tumaas ng 13.1%, at financial and insurance activities na tumaas ng 8.9%. Ang mga sektor na may pinakamalaking kontribusyon sa pagtaas ng GDP sa ika-apat na quarter ng 2023 ay ang mga sumusunod: financial and insurance activities na nag-ambag ng 1.1 percentage points, wholesale and retail trade, repair of motor vehicles and motorcycles na nag-ambag ng 1.0 percentage point, at construction na nag-ambag ng 0.6 percentage point. Sa demand side, ang imports of services ay nagtala ng pinakamataas na paglago na 21.0% sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023. Ito ay sinundan ng durable equipment na tumaas ng 14.6%, exports of services na tumaas ng 12.3%, at construction na tumaas ng 10.1%. Sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang valuables ay nagtala ng pinakamataas na paglago na nasa 28.2%. Ito ay sinundan ng imports of services na tumaas ng 25.7%, exports of services na tumaas ng 13.6%, at construction na tumaas naman ng 9.0%. Sa ika-apat na quarter ng taong 2023, ang mga sektor na may pinakamalaking kontribusyon sa pagtaas ng GDP sa expenditure side ay ang mga sumusunod: household final consumption expenditure na nag-ambag ng 4.0 percentage points, construction nag-ambag ng 1.3 percentage points, at durable equipment na nag-ambag ng 0.8 percentage point. Samantala, para sa kabuuang taon ng 2023, ang may malaking contribution ay ang mga sumusunod: household final consumption expenditure na nag-ambag ng 4.1 percentage points, construction na nag-ambag ng 1.3 percentage points, at durable equipment na nag-ambag naman ng 0.5 percentage point. Ang Philippine Statistics Authority ay malugod na nagpapasalamat sa inyong pagdalo sa National Accounts Press Conference para sa ika-apat na quarter at kabuuang taon ng 2023. Salamat at magandang umaga sa ating lahat.
Ngayon, atin naman pong pakinggan si NEDA Secretary Arsenio M. Balisacan para sa pahayag niya ukol sa 2023 fourth quarter and full year 2023 performance of the Philippine economy.
Colleagues in government, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Today, we are pleased to see that our economy has sustained its growth, expanding by 5.6% in the fourth quarter of 2023, resulting in a GDP growth rate of 5.6% for the entire year. While this growth is below our target of 6 to 7% for 2023, it keeps us in the position of being one of the best performing economies in Asia, among those that have already released their quarter 4 2023 GDP growth figures. We follow Vietnam with 6.7%, while surpassing China 5.2% and Malaysia 3.4%. More importantly, our full year GDP for 2023 is now 8.6% higher than pre-pandemic levels. Moreover, the Q4 economic performance validates the strategies and policy directions outlined in the Philippine Development Plan 2023-2028. Household spending year on year grew faster in Q4 versus the growth in Q3. We welcome the robust growth in spending for restaurants and hotels, transport and recreation, reflecting the improvements in the labor market and steady growth in remittances. However, we are concerned about the low growth in food spending due to high food prices, though inflation has moderated in recent months. Moving forward, we need to relentlessly manage elevated food prices, particularly improving the efficiency and resiliency of the agriculture value chain, utilizing strategic trade policy when domestic production is inadequate, and preventing anti-competitive practices in the marketplace. The growth in total investments accelerated to 11.2% in Q4 2023, a turnaround from the 1.4% contraction in Q3. This resulted in a 5.4% growth for the full year. The robust investment expansion during the quarter was driven by significant growth in fixed capital, particularly the expansion of durable equipment. As I have mentioned in other fora, nothing less than massive sustained investment is needed to achieve high-quality job-creating growth and inclusion. Thus, a major effort will be made to address critical factors affecting investment decisions. We shall improve the ease of doing business through digitalization and continuous streamlining of policies and regulations, accelerate the execution of game-changing public infrastructure projects, facilitate more private investment in energy and telecommunications, and upskill our workforce. Meanwhile, construction sustained its double-digit growth of 10.1% Q4 2023, owing to the upbeat private and public construction activities at 7.5% and 14.7% respectively. This sector is expected to benefit significantly from the Build Better More program and the administration's flagship housing program, the Pambansang Pabahay para sa Filipino Housing Program, or for PHs. On the other hand, government spending contracted by 1.8% in Q4 2023 from 6.7% growth in Q3 2023. This brings the full year growth in government spending to 0.4%, mainly due to the fiscal consolidation program. Recall that in 2022, the government spent a lot of resources on the vaccination program on top of the elections in May. Or held in May. The preceding, notwithstanding, will continue to implement the measures started in Q3 2023 to improve program implementation by the government. These measures include adopting the integrated financial management information systems by all government instrumentalities as directed by Executive Order 29, Series of 2023. The weak global economy weighed heavily on our export sector, which declined by 2.6% in Q4. The decline came mainly from the deep contraction in goods exports, although services exports grew by 12.3%. Goods exports declined by 7.3% for the entire year, but services exports increased by 13.6%. We expect growth in services to maintain its trajectory as international tourism rebounds. We will present international tourists with a pleasant experience, beginning with improved airport services, simplified travel requirements, and most significantly, a diverse range of tourism products. Meanwhile, IT BPM, a big part of the services sector's exports, will benefit from the improvements in our digital infrastructure. The goal is moving forward to adapt to the sector's evolving needs by climbing the value chain and providing more complex IT BPM services. We'll expand the digital upskilling program to ensure that there will be a competitive pool of human resources for the sector. Growth in industry. Our industry sector moderated to 3.2% in Q4 2023, bringing the sector's full-year growth to 3.6%. The industry posted a meager 0.4% growth in Q4 2023 on a seasonally adjusted quarter-on-quarter basis. Moving forward, the implementation of the 4P8s will fuel growth in the sector. We must encourage expansion in the sector serving the construction industry, manufacturing, mining and quarrying, and EGW or electricity, gas and water. We will expand skills training programs, both in scope and coverage, to ensure an adequate supply of construction and related workers. The agriculture sector grew by 1.4% in Q4 2023, up from 0.9% in Q3 of 2023, which brings the full year growth to 1.2%. Demand for agricultural output will remain vital, whether for household final consumption, industry inputs, or exports. We'll need to improve the sector's competitiveness using R&D, cutting-edge technology, upgraded post-production facilities, value-adding investments, and improved packaging and marketing, to name a few. To ensure we have the fiscal resources to implement the above-mentioned strategies, the government will streamline, digitalize, and enhance our tax administration systems by implementing the Ease of Paying Taxes Act. We'll optimize the use of resources by strengthening the linkages of planning, budgeting, and operational units within and among agencies. At the same time, we'll work with legislators to enact new revenue-generating measures to build a solid fiscal foundation. In his message last Sunday, President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. called for the government to be swift and punctual in its delivery of services and implementation of projects as we work toward realizing Bagong Pilipinas. We will heed the call and work with all our government colleagues to accelerate the implementation of the Philippine Development Plan to sustain the momentum and cement the gains we have made as a people and as a country. Today, the NEDA will release the Philippine Development Report, or PDR 2023, to the public. The PDR identifies the critical programs, projects, and policies began and implemented in the past year or 2023. As an evidence-based report, it evaluates our country's performance concerning the outcome indicators identified in the PDP and includes updates on the Marcos administration's legislative agenda. As a forward-looking document, the PDR considers and anticipates internal and external developments and scenarios. Finally, it presents the lessons we have learned and lays down plans of action to ensure we remain on track to meet our goals by 2028. I urge the public to read the report to see how we have fared and how we see ourselves moving forward this year. Thank you.
So government spending naman, I think it contracted 1.8% during the quarter. Apologies if I've missed the reasons, but may I know why did it contract? And is this a one-off? Will you encourage or push government agencies to spend more to help support growth going forward? Yeah.
Yung kabu, the full planned government spending for 2023 kasi is not as high as the one for 2022. Remember, 2022, we're still going into, it was an election year, and still we're adjusting the vaccination programs. So mataas talaga yung spending in 2022. At the same time, we decided to go for fiscal consolidation. Kaya it was intentional na hindi mataas yung growth ng government spending for 2023, because we want to achieve that fiscal consolidation, which means lowering the fiscal deficit at saka yung government debt, no? But still are able to provide enough for social protection, mga ayuda for the poor, at saka yung financing the critical programs of government sa health, sa education, saka sa infrastructure program natin.
Sorry, last question on my part, because yesterday the IMF raised its global growth forecast, including the United States and China, and both are major trading partners of the Philippines. May we get your outlook on, you know, on trade this year? Will you expect a rebound compared to the performance that we've seen, you know, this last year?
Yeah, I just saw the report this morning of the IMF. No, the outlook for 2024 is a bit better than in their October report last year. No, and I think that's a good indication, and it's a good thing, despite the challenges. No, that, and if you look at those outlooks prepared by IMF for various countries, it's interesting to note that so looking at the emerging countries, for example, that the Philippines, the outlook for the Philippines by the IMF was the second highest, best, you know, among our, the emerging economies. No, the highest I've seen here is India, 6.5, and they have us at 6.0, and there's no other country that had that. Of course, Vietnam is not here, so maybe if there's another country, that might be Vietnam. But, you know, among the emerging economies in the world, we, despite, you know, our forecast lower than what we are aiming in government, it's still a very impressive and I think a encouraging indication.
Thank you very much, Secretary.